Hey everyone, I am painting a 6 by 6 inch canvas today. And as usual, I'm sketching my composition onto my canvas with my pastel. That'll be it for my leaves, and I'm gonna have a bunch of different size flowers. For my palette today, I am using primary magenta, turquoise, Hansa yellow and titanium white. I'm gonna try to make my flowers mostly bright magenta with maybe just a tiny bit of peach. And a little bit of white. I just wet my brush. And I'm going to start today by layering my flowers. Mix a little yellow in with my magenta to make an orange color. This flower will be a little bit lighter than the others, maybe. We'll see if I change my mind as I go along. If you can hear that sound, it's raining. It's kind of loud on the windows right now. Okay, now I'm going to switch over to my leaves. I think I'm going to change the direction of the leaves that I drew. I think I'm going to have them one go off the side this way, and then one go over the top. And I'll start off with turquoise. That's too much. I wet my brush a little, and I'm going to add some of this to part of my leaves and carry it over to the sides. I'm also going to put some of this under my flowers here and a little in between. This turquoise and yellow makes a nice green. And I'm going to add this to my vase. I'm going to lighten it up a little and use some of this lighter green for my leaves. I don't want my leaves to be all the exact same color, so I'm going to mix a few different greens, light and dark, some with a little more yellow, just to get some more variation. Add some of this also between my flowers. And I'm going to mix hopefully a light gray color for my negative space. I'm going to try to take some of the paint that's already on my palette to mix the gray. If you mix all of your primaries with the white, you can get a nice gray color. sort of a green gray that I mixed, but I like it. I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna make it a little bit more blue. And I'm just gonna add this to all the areas between my flowers and leaves. Grab a larger brush. Okay, now I'm gonna let this dry for a couple of minutes so that the sides are dry and I'll be able to pick it back up while I'm painting my flowers and leaves a little more, putting on that second layer. I'm gonna put a little of this between the flowers. If you don't like the shape of your leaves, you can reshape them now. Okay, let's let this dry for a few minutes. Okay, I cleaned my brush and I'm going to start layering my flowers a little bit more. I'm gonna try to have a couple of light flowers and a couple of dark flowers. I think I'm going mostly magenta and pink on these, but I'm not sure yet. My sides are mostly dry. corners are always tricky to get everything to match up. They don't have to be perfect though. And I am going to try to keep some of these areas dark and some light to kind of draw your eye back. The darker area should draw your eye back to add some depth to your flowers. I'm going to make some of these a little bit more peach. Mixing a little orange right now with my magenta and yellow. It's actually a reddish orange, pinkish orange. It's cute though. I'm still always amazed at how many colors I can mix with just three or four colors on my palette. This will be cute in here. Okay, and while this layer dries, I'm going to switch back to my leaves. Okay, I think my turquoise is still wet there, so I am going to use that. Make some green. And some of these areas I want to have more of a green, a yellow green, and then some areas I'm going to have more of a blue green just for variation. And you can do that with just your turquoise and yellow in varying amounts. I want to darken up some of these turquoise areas. And I'll add some white. I wipe off my brush so I can get a nice light green here. And I'm gonna add some lighter marks into my vase. My vase seems kind of simple, but I think I like it. So I might not do too much more to my vase. I'm gonna leave it alone for a little bit and reassess in a few minutes. I'm just gonna check the sides here and make sure everything matches up. Which it mostly does. Okay, we're getting there. We're gonna start wrapping this up, but I definitely wanna put one more layer of paint on my flowers before I finish. Okay, so I let that dry for a few minutes. And I am gonna work on my flowers, but I'm also gonna change up the color on the negative space a tiny bit. I'm gonna do that last. I'm darkening up the magenta areas. And now I'm going to go over these pink areas, and I'm trying to add just a little bit of white. sorry about that. Okay, so I'm going to let that dry and I'm going to work on my negative space and I am going to lighten it up. I'm going to grab just a tiny bit of turquoise. I'm going to add in more white. This is going to lighten things up a bit. I'm not even going right up to the edge of my flowers. I'm going to leave a little green glow around them. I like that much better. And just a few touch-ups here on my flowers. Thank you. The last thing I am going to do, two last things. I am going to make this flower, I'll give it a little bit more shape or make it bigger. Check all my edges. And you know I love my teal, especially next to that magenta. I'm gonna take a small brush and I'm gonna put a little bit, a couple of dots in here. And a little bit in there. Subtle. As I'm looking to wrap this up, I can see that I just want to darken some of this turquoise. And then I will be finished. I am going to try to paint 30 flower paintings in the next 30 days. This is painting number 2. If you want to be notified every time I post a new video, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. You can also find me on most other social media, including Instagram and Pinterest, at Elle Byers Art. Thanks for watching.